Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan Rebel our lecture Sir Eko Saputra MPD as the lecture of CCU class and all of my beloved friends. The presentation today is about cultural differences between Indonesia and China. But first of all, I would like to introduce our group. We are coming from group 3. And the members are me, Siti Nurhaliza, as the moderator, Karisma Wilantara, Sinta Nurfauzia, and Fitrianti Putri. Next. Next slide. In this presentation, there are three topics that will be discussed, which are the difference in language between Indonesia and China, the difference in traditional clothes between Indonesia and China, and the difference in traditional games between Indonesia and China. So without further ado, let's start with. For the first speaker, I will invite Karisma Wilantara to explain the material. For Karisma Wilantara, time is yours.
Language. Language is social communication tool in the form of the sound symbol system produced from human speech. The main function of language is a means of communication between humans. Through language, a person can convey ideas, thoughts, and feelings to others. Every country has a different language. Indonesia. There is a basic sentence pattern in Indonesia, which is orally and in writing, which consists of subject, predicate, object, dan keterangan. For example, Esi membeli seekor ayam di pasar swalayan. Esi bought a chicken at the supermarket. This is the example. Good morning, selamat pagi. Good afternoon, selamat siang. Good night, selamat malam. Nice to meet you. Senang bertemu denganmu. Goodbye, selamat jalan. How are you? Apa kabar? I'm fine or I'm good. Saya baik-baik saja. Thank you. Terima kasih. Please, tolong. Excuse me. Maaf. China. In the use of Chinese, which is usually orally and in writing, there's a basic sentence structure pattern consists of subject description, predicate, and object. As an example, Ana Haotian Yao Kutang Sinsilan. Ana di Lusa Gutu New Zealand. Ana pergi ke Selandia Baru Lusa. For example, good morning. Zhao Sang Hao, good afternoon. Zhang Wu Hao, good night. Wan An, nice to meet you. Jian Dao Ni Han Gao Seng, goodbye. Yu Pingan, how are you? Ni Hao Ma, I'm fine or I'm good. Hu Han Hao, thank you. Xie xie. Please. Bang Zi. Excuse me. Darau Yixia. Okay, that's all from me. Back to moderator.
Thank you, Karisma, for this, the material that have been explained. For the next material is about traditional clothing. The second materi will be delivered by Sinta Nur Fauzia. For Sinta, time is yours.
Okay, the next material is traditional clothing. Traditional clothing is a symbol of national identity. Traditional clothing represents the culture of a nation that makes it different from other nations. Indonesia. Kebaya is one of the traditional Indonesian clothes. Kebaya is made of various materials such as silk, cotton, and polyester, which are used in sarung, batik, and songket. First, kebaya Sunda. Kebaya Sunda generally has SU-shaped collar, unique with a length that covers the hips. This kebaya has bright colors such as red, yellow, like purple, and white. This kebaya is mixed and matched with accessories such as necklace, bracelets, rings, buns, and earrings to make it look elegant. Next. Second, beskap. Beskap is usually used during official activities such as traditional ceremony, weddings, and national gatherings. Beskap has an asymmetrical cut in the front and back. The aim is to make it easier for the carriers to wear on the back. Next slide. Okay, China. Qipao is the traditional dress of the Chinese, the tribe of men, which the underwent a major change in the style of clothing. Qipao generally have the characteristics of having a high, long collar and closing buttons near the shoulder, and there are slits on the left and right at the bottom. Qipao is usually made of silk. Tribal silk can show a person's status and wealth. However, Qipao can be made using other materials such as brocades, velvet, satin, cotton, and checkered. Okay, back to moderator.
Thank you, Sinta, for the explanation. Now we move to traditional game. Traditional game is a form of activity that develops from a community habit. Traditional game is part of the community's cultural heritage that is still maintained today. Usually, traditional game play in groups with the aim of practicing honesty, cooperation, and responsibility. In every region and country have traditional games that are played using regional languages that are characteristic of the region and the country. Next. Indonesia has traditional game in each region. This traditional game is played according to the customs of each region. Some of the traditional Indonesian games that are still played are Gobak Sodor and Congklak. Next. Gobak Sodor is one of the traditional games in the Daerah Istimewa Yogyakarta. Gobak Sodor is an opponent's game to reach the finish line. This game is played by two teams of 3 till 10 people, each with a balanced number. The second is Congkla. Congkla is a very ancient cultural heritage. The traditional game of Congkla in Indonesia has many different names in each region. However, in Sumatra, this game is called Congkla. This game is played by two people. The main media used is a Congkla board and 98 Congkla seats. The Congkla board consists of 16 holes consisting of 14 small holes facing each other and 12 large holes on both sides. Each small hole is filled with 7 Congkla seats. Congkla game can be played by children to adults. For next material will be delivered by Fitrianti Putri.
Okay, thank you, moderator. The next material is about China. In China, there are also several traditional games that are preserved and can still be played today. Some of the traditional Chinese games that are still played are Xiangqi, Chinese chess, Weiqi, and Chinese checkers. Okay, the first is Xiangqi, Chinese chess. Xiangqi is a game from China that is played by two people and belongs to a group strategy board game with chess. This game represents a battle between two armies, with the primary object being to checkmate the enemy's general or king. Among 16 pieces of chess, there are 7 Chinese characters, which are the general, the counselor, the minister, the horse, the chariot, the cannon, and the foot soldier. Each character is assigned with restrictions and power, and your main goal is to capture the general. The second is Weiqi. Weiqi or Go is a strategy board game between two players originating from China. The game was invented in China more than 2,500 years ago and is believed to be the oldest board game continuously played to the present day. The next slide. And the last is Chinese checkers. The Chinese checkers board is in the shape of a 6-pointed star. Each point of the star is a triangle consisting often holes of 4 holes to each side. The interior of the board is a hexagon with each side 5 holes long. Each triangle is a different color and there are 6 sets of 10 marbles with corresponding colors. I think that's all from me. Back to the moderator.
Thank you to the speaker who explained the material very well. Now, let's move on to the question and answer session. Guys, if you have any question, you can ask us directly. Is there any question?
I want to ask.
Okay, Anissa.
My name is Anissa Pujastari. I am from Group 6. My question is, in your opinion, do Congkla and Weiqi have a similar? Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Anissa, for this question. Is there any question?
I want to ask.
Okay.
My question is how we can preserve the kebaya as a traditional clothes. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Restu, for the question. Guys, give me some time to answer your question. Okay, for Anissa question will be answered by Fitrianti Putri.
Okay, I will answer the question from Anissa. In your opinion, do Chongqing and Wilkie have a similar? We have been talked about Chongqing and Wilkie. Although this game is played by two people, Chongqing and Wilkie are two different games. Chongqing is played by two players take turns choosing a small hole to move the seeds in their hand. The game will stop if one player loses all their seeds, and the player who gets the most seeds is the winner. Meanwhile, Wilkie is played by one player uses white stones and the other black. Players take turns placing stones on empty spots of the board and can be moved. A stone is removed from the board if it is surrounded by opposite stones at all points. I think that's all.
Thank you, Fitrianti Putri, for the answer. For Anissa, is it clear?
Clear. Thank you for answer.
Okay. You're welcome. And for rest of question will be answered by Sinta Nurfauzia. For Sinta, time is yours.
Okay, I will answer from Christus' question. The question is, how can we preserve the kabaya as a traditional clothing? Okay, the answer is traditional clothing is the identity of a country. If it is not preserved, the identity will be lost. As an Indonesian citizen, the thing that must be done to maintain the preservation of the kabaya as a national identity is to always use the kabaya at traditional cultural events. Besides that, the kabaya can be used as a reference to be worn in every formal or semi-formal events, so that the preservation of the kabaya is maintained. Okay, that's all the instructions.
Thank you, Sinta, for the answer. And Restu, is it clear for you?
Clear. Thank you for the answer, Sinta.
Okay. You're welcome. Okay, guys. I think that's all from us for the presentation. We hope that our presentation will be useful for all of us. I am, as a moderator, would like to say sorry if we have made mistakes. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.